Welcome back, everyone. This is MJ with MinIO. In this video, we're going to actually go through the lab setup and talk about all the components that you need if you do want to follow along and set up a lab environment with us. So for this course, we will be using Rancher K3S. That's either K3S deployed natively on top of Linux or using Rancher K3D to run K3S inside Docker containers. But we'll talk about that setup as we get to each of these points. You will also need the following components to follow along with this course. And I'm going to walk you through in individual videos on installing every one of these components on a Linux host. But the first thing that you need is a Linux host. And we recommend that you have at least 8 CPU and 16 gigs of RAM to get the best performance. You don't want to bottleneck anything, particularly if you're following along in the course and you're deploying multiple tenants or something like that. We don't want the resources of the Linux system to be what's constraining you. You're also going to need kubectl. Kubectl is the command line interface for interfacing with the Kubernetes API. There's a plugin manager for kubectl called Krew, which you'll need for a number of different tasks. There's Helm, which is a package manager for Kubernetes. And we will be doing some Helm installations of MinIO as well. K3S and DirectPV is option one. So if you want to deploy a single node Kubernetes cluster with K3S directly on top of Linux, and then leverage something like DirectPV for your persistent volumes, we'll show you how to do that. Option two is actually to install Docker and then run K3D, which is Kubernetes or K3S rather inside Docker containers. That is able to simulate a much more robust cluster because you can have multiple nodes, both server and agent nodes running on a single host, but they are all just Docker containers. So that's option two. Choose your own path and use what works best for you. You'll also need Ingress Nginx. You could use something else like Traffic or another ingress controller, but we do recommend Ingress Nginx because that is the default ingress controller for Kubernetes. And lastly, you'll need the MinIO client for interacting with some of the deployments that you do. So with that, if you are still looking to do this, please join us in the next video and we'll actually get started installing some of these components. Thanks for watching.